conferences. The party is expected, supposed to raise at least $8 million through its fundraising efforts. And these will cover the following areas. We will be requesting provinces to make their contributions of 100,000 towards this important development. And they will also be expected to donate in kind. We're expecting food stuffs and other related items to be donated by the, or to be brought by the provinces, including meat or cattle. We have also provided for leadership contributions. Now this is a normal development, a normal thing that we do each time we are to embark on a program of this nature. Leadership, I'm talking about Politburo, the leaders in the private sector that have always supported our cause, and national leadership from this central committee and the provinces. We have other categories, you know, where you have members of parliament and senators, councillors making their contributions. And these contributions are to be made to the party and deposited into the party account. And those members of the public who are supporters of the party should always ensure that their contributions go towards the party and through the party account. We have received a lot of complaints from well-wishers about people who have been using the party to raise funds and advising that these funds should be banked into accounts which are not party accounts. But again, I want to thank you, colleagues, for your usual support, and want to assure you that all your contributions will be accounted for. And I'm appealing to all well-wishers who are here and as well outside in the private sector, public sector, and now from individuals who have supported party activities in the manner they've supported. We, as I said earlier on, expect quite a big number of attendance of delegates, since now it's going to be, since the conference has been turned into an extraordinary congress, where there'll be a lot of invited guests from within and outside the country, making the numbers a bit higher than those that we have projected to. And I want to say we continue to receive this support, financial support from oil issuers, even before the announcement of the extraordinary congress at the end of the year. And it is my appeal that we continue with the spirit that you have shown to us each time we come to you. I'm talking about the generality of our Zimbabwe. We have always supported our cause. With those, really, this is just a launch of our fundraising effort, so that people are in no doubt about the authenticity of our appeals in the respective provinces and also in the structures of the party. But before I call upon my deputy, Comrade Tavengwa, to say the final remarks, I would ask the media to raise questions, queries, if any, so that we are clear in our minds as we leave this room. certain donated vehicles, tractors, and the other implements relating to those donations that will be raffled. So and many others.
And the exhibition.
And the exhibition will be having some companies, and we are overwhelmed. The companies, most companies want to exhibit at our during the conference. So there are quite a number of activities that we have embarked upon that aim to raise funds. We will be talking to individual companies or individuals, you know, for their support in any manner that is convenient to them. But you know, as a mass party, we are convinced the generality of our people, including companies, will support this work because
the OFU, the ZANU-PF Secretary for Finance. Allow me, Honorable Ministers, who are also members of the Fundraising Committee, that's Honorable Ndenge, Mandiwanzira, and Minister of State, Honorable Shikukwa, to thank you really for having attended this launch. Our directors and staff who arranged this launch, and then of course members of the press who are here. I am also happy that the department has arranged snacks and drinks for those who are here, so that you quench the thirst. It's quite hot out there, I understand, but this is also in preparation for the hard work before us, which is the raising of the $8 million. It's not easy, but we know it's possible. It's possible through your support and the generality of Zimbabweans who are always in support of our fundraising programs. So we also call those who benefited from the labor reform, those who did harvest through the Commander Agriculture, to come on board and contribute towards this noble cause, because when we meet, it's really to chart the way forward in terms of how the country, the nation, will be governed and will be preparing for the next coming years. So make your contribution towards this noble cause. Thank you, Honorable Minister.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.